All right, welcome back. I hope you are coming back to watch round three of our Escalation Tournament. We have a cool scum on scum list here. Caleb is back on stream. He was in our round one game with his three banana pirates, his three banyares. Ooh, it looks like I missed updating one of them. So one of them is not PS3, it's definitely PS1. Sorry about that. So Caleb is back on the right. He's still got his three pirates with concussions and guidance chips. He's added into this list Dengar with wired painbot R5PA, Zuckus, and inertial dampeners. And with this round, he's had the addition of a Syndicate Thug Y-Wing with TLT and unhinged astromech. So he just keeps adding power on power here. Mike, first time on the stream today, he's on the left-hand side of the screen. He has a Jakku Gunrunner, our first quad jumper of the day. That ship has Ketsu Onyo Crew, which lets you keep a target lock, or excuse me, a tractor beam token on a ship that you have in arc at range 1 to 2 for the next round. And he also has the Space Tug Tractor Array, which allows him at range 1 in arc to use his action to give you a tractor beam token. That's a cool combo. He also has Pelab Gadali with a TLT Zuckus and wired EPT. Asajj Ventress with the tidal and gyroscopic targeting. Push the Limit, Lats Razzie, and Black Market Slicer Tools. Kind of a scary Asajj. And rounding out his list is Nadru in the Z with Lone Wolf, Guidance Chips, Glitter Stim, and Cluster Missiles. So a very scary Nadru. And we got some rock placement going on here. All right, so this is a 90-minute round. And this is round three of our Escalation Tournament. I hope you guys enjoy it. I hope the commentary is not terrible as I do it by myself. I'm sure it's fairly bad. If you have any questions, throw it in the Twitch chat or send, you know, you can send us an email, send us a tweet, something at 3.2 Company is our Twitter. 3.2company at gmail.com is our email. So here we go. Time has started. Round three is underway. So we're just putting out some rocks, putting out our ships. Let's see how our players decide to lay out their group. All right, so Z's gonna stay up there in formation, be this scary little wall of concussion missiles you do not want to be on the end of. TLTY gonna go play around in the rocks, seems good. Has unhinged, so threes are all over the place, so that's lovely. Asajj baiting the Z's, maybe? What do you think Asajj is doing here? It's a really interesting setup. Kind of scary, I'm terrified. Yeah, it looks like Dengar is getting over there. So Asajj is kind of baiting this whole list. That's pretty interesting. And it looks like Asajj's auxiliary arc is painted forward. We got a pre-game handshake. We got a little bit of sportsmanship going on. I don't know what's going on. That's always exciting to see. Actually, who gives a crap? It's a pre-game handshake. Let's see if they take the game well at the end. Dials are going down quickly. Let's see. And Nadru is kind of the outlier here. Nadru can be either a huge waste of, you know, 20 to 30 points, or can be your list All-Star as it wrecks Dengar early. So here we go. Putting down dials, and we are off for round three of the tournament. I hope if you like the stream that you'll continue to watch when we get on. We're not as consistent as we need to be, but we've been trying to do some Wednesday streaming as well. And we're hoping to get that a little bit more under control. We're also doing a bunch of podcasting, not all exclusively X-Wing, but a hefty chunk of it definitely is X-Wing. Check us out at 3.2company.com. The point is spelled out. And this is also, I mean, this is a pretty scary Dengar. I mean, he basically has, like, improvised Lone Wolf because Zuckuss is going to give him wired rerolls. R5P8's going to make him a pain, even a bigger pain to shoot at. You know, you're going to take a damage a lot of the times, 50% of the time when you shoot at him. And inertial dampeners, he's going to stay in place around that you're not prepared for it. Here we go. Dials are down. I'm guessing the Z's are just going to scream forward. Oh. Excuse me. Actually, it's pretty slow. Slow roll. He thinks he's not going to take that bait. He doesn't want to get too out of position in case Lats decides to make some moves. Seems smart. Now, Lats also has PTL. So she generally wants to go really fast. So it looks like the front Z slow rolled a little bit. The ones in the back are going a little bit faster. Maybe kind of stagger his guys out a little bit. He's going to take a focus there. Let's see what the last Z is going to do. Is he also going to go two forward? He's also just going to go one forward, it looks like. So one kind of popped out a little bit in front there. And they all take a focus. Next up should be the Jakku Gunrunner. He's going to go as fast as that ship can go, which is three. Not a fast ship. Even though Rey and Finn were running to a quad jumper in Force Awakens, you would think it would be a faster ship as they're trying to outrun TIE FO as one of the fastest ship in the galaxy. But sure, Palob's gonna go as fast as he can. Well, I think three, not taking a stress. Those are the cool Team Covenant Awaken tokens. I love those tokens. So Saj actually going forward. Asajj is going forward and is going to probably going to get into some concussion missiles next round. Maybe Last Razzie gives her a chance to weather them. Also maybe Nadru and Asajj can wreck two TLTs. That's certainly a possibility. That's a scary situation though if I'm Asajj, staring down the barrel of three concussion missiles. All right, Dengar moves last. No shots, of course. First round, nobody went too fast. Caleb takes his Myriad tokens back, and we are back in the game here. We are returning to planning phase. Back to Dials is back, so we'll do our best not to say their name out loud. We're going to say return to planning phase. All right, getting some dials down into round two of this 90-minute match. Round two of the match, round three of the tournament, Escalation Tournament here at Demolition Games in Salt Lake City, Utah. This is 3.2 Company streaming. Unfortunately, no alcohol on the premises. We're not as lucky as a lot of states where our local game store can have a adult beverage to partake in. So I'm stuck drinking Arnold Palmer's. Not as drunk or as salty as I would like to be on a Saturday. Well, I do appreciate you guys watching. Those of you who have tuned in for even a little bit, I hope that you've enjoyed it. The ship, the large ship at the very top on the right-hand side is a Jumpmaster Stengar. Our camera just kind of cuts it off because it's too tall on its peg. As we come in a little bit, should be able to see the ships better. And if my players will stop bumping the table, we should get a little bit steadier of a stream. It's hard not to put your arms on the table and shift it around. Here we go. I'm guessing Front Z's going to scream as fast as he can.
Get that target lock if possible. Looks like he's definitely got it. Set up concussion missile.
Just
has it.
There's the target lock.
We're going to call that C1-1.
Actually, I'm going to go really quickly and check on my players just to check the numbering on those three Zs. I can maybe number them for the stream so we can kind of all stay on the same page of what Z is doing what. Looking for the target lock. It's real close. Let's see if he gets it. He does. All right, the Z all the way forward is Z number 2. The one on the left closest to the screen is Z number 1, and the one that just flew up is Z number 3. Let's see if I can remember that through the game without running out every 2 seconds. Boy, I'm bad at this. Ah! Oops. Oh, I hate Max. All right. So I missed a little bit of action trying to fix that. Asajj going to go fast. As Asajj will. 3 hard. Unfortunately, she didn't move her auxiliary arc, so she'll need to do it this time with the push the limit situation. She's in a bad way. She's going to take 12 dice as it currently stands. And it's probably in TLT range as well. The other really rough part of this match currently is that Nidru most likely will not have Lone Wolf. It's going to be hard to stay range 3 of both the Quad and Asajj. But let's see what she can do. No, she's definitely not going to have Lone Wolf. But going to try to somehow help wipe one of these Zs off the board early. If Asajj can somehow make it through Dengar 3 Zs and a TLTY, that's one good Asajj. Lads Razzy, going to try to stay alive with an extra evade token from stressing one of them. Nidru looking for a target lock there. Going to find it on, I believe that one. Did I say that one was number 1? I believe it's number 2. Yeah, I think it's number 1. Dengar just going to kind of come up. 2 straight, no worries. Going to have shots on Asajj. Thinking about a focus, looks like he takes it. Unfortunately, Palob and the Quad Jumper are quite a bit out of the fight here. Asajj is going to stress that front one. And here we go. Dengar onto Asajj. Let's go to the dice cam. Whoa, wrong one. Dice cam time. Oh, I'm going to have to go fix it. It's off just a tiny bit. All right, hit focus from Dengar. Oh, yeah, Dengar doesn't have the title. Not as scary. And he spends the focus. 2 hits. And 1 evade. So it looks like one shield on Asajj. Alright, hold on, let me check. I might have missed something there. Alright, so this should be Nidru shooting here. Hit crit. Oh, lone wolf. Oh, no, just a crit. And here we go with the Z. Three dice, got the evade, safe. Must have been range three on number one there. No damage. All right, so now TLTY is probably, oh no, Asajj will be next. Now Asajj does have the title. He's able to maybe tractor beam one onto a rock. That's a good point, I kind of forgot about that. So that looks like one hit and one. So that just means a shield on one of them. I believe that's number one is going to take the shield. I am really missing here. Go look. So, Binyari Pilot took took one shield there. I believe he forgot his, so there's TLT1 from the Y-Wing. He forgot the Tractor Beam token, unfortunately. So that's going to be a shield. Here comes TLT2. Rolling again. Spend it. So here comes the roll again. So two shields. So Asajj is down to no shields currently. Okay. So here comes the first concussion missiles from number two, Binyari Pilot number two. And that'll do it. So that's going to be a crit and two hits. So she's definitely taking a crit here. Oh, nope. It only turns one up. Spends a focus. And Asajj will spend the stress and not take the damage. So no damage there. All right, so number one is also going to shoot concussions, it looks like. Another concussion. Here we go. All right, so three hits and a crit. And one evade. So hit, crit. So Asajj is down to four. Let's see if Asajj can somehow make it to the next round. All I'm going to go really quick and check on something. This game is a little bit confusing for me.
What was the crit? My bad. Twice now. That's twice my bad.
All right, so three's now going to shoot. Looks like I forgot about three. Three with one. No evades. The crit that Asajj took was weapons failure, so he's down a red die. I mean, Asajj made it through that barrage. But that was a tough situation. With TLTs, all those missiles, Dengar. Asajj only taking 3-hole. Not the worst thing I've ever seen. So now I think we're at dials. And I'm just going to double check, make sure I got the hole correct here.
So sorry.
All right, so yeah, we are at dials here. Asajj took a beating there. Mike's a little disappointed with his setup. He thought maybe he could bait the joust and he could make that too hard. After he got the rock set up and he got his ship where it was, he kind of thought the better of it. Didn't want to land on a rock turn one. Maybe it would have been better. He could have, you know, got out of dodge a little bit. So here we go. Here comes the Z. So only number three currently has a concussion missile. The other two have shot their payload. The Thug is still going to be a problem, and Dengar is still going to be a problem. The Quad Jumper and Paylob hope to get in the fight. If not next turn, the next. That's kind of the issue here. The setup was a little bit too spaced out, I think, for our left-hand side player, Mike. Asajj was kind of left out on her own without any support. And Paylob and the Jakku Gunrunner will be probably too little too late to get him back in the game. We'll see, though. We've seen crazier things happen. But we'll see how it goes. Hope you guys are enjoying the stream so far. Hope you can hear everything. We are at the third round here, both in the players and the tournament. Here at Escalation Tournament at Demolition Games in Salt Lake City. This is 3.2 Company streaming. I'm Brody. I hope you enjoyed the commentary so far. It's a little bit hard to do one-sided commentary here without anybody to play off of or to ask questions to, but I hope I'm doing an okay job on the whole. The Z's are just going to keep turning in, going to keep pestering. Caleb showed in the first game that he's really good at keeping those Z's in the fight, you know, if not shooting their missiles, at least pestering with their two dice primary, their, you know, range one, three dice with the bonus, you know, and just keeping them in there, keeping them actioned, and making them a nuisance. I think he's done a really good job at that. The one with the missile is the one that is not facing the exact same direction. So that's number three. Number two is the one closest to the rack. And pilot number one is the one... Oh, excuse me. Pilot number one is the one closest to Dengar. I'm probably off a little bit there. One is the one with damage, so one is the one closest to the rock. Two is the closest to Dengar. Three is the one off to the side. Gunrunner gonna go as fast as he can. Three bank. Try to get in there. Try to get a tractor beam. He's looking for that tractor beam. Doesn't have it, and he's angry about it. He's really close. Really close. But he doesn't get it. So now he's got to think about what he wants to do action-wise. Really wanted to get that tractor beam. The Jakku Gunrunner is really a scary proposition here for our right-hand side player, Caleb. You definitely don't want to get into tractor beam range. So what I'm guessing is the TLT and the Zs will kind of turn onto the Gunrunner and try to get him off this round. I could be wrong. That's kind of my thought process. I don't want to deal with that nonsense. Palob's going to probably be in range of the Y-Wing with the TLT. It's real close one way or the other. I think he's got the Y-Wing and maybe even that number one Z. Could be some Palob with the focus there. Now, if I remind you, Palob has Zuckuss, Wired, and TLT. Not too, you know, worried about stress other than the Hawk can't move that fast. Asajj is going to bump here. Is going to bump a lot. Is probably going to go all the way back and bump into Nadru after this is all said and done. They're going to try to see if they can get Asajj in between Nadru and that front Z, which is number one. Nope. Going to go all the way back. Gonna go all the way back. It was probably better anyway because with gyroscopic targeting, with the auxiliary arc where it was, wouldn't be able to. Auxiliary arc's popping off. Wouldn't be able to move his arc and would not have a shot at that point. Nah, he would still have shots, but as it is, he's definitely not taking a shot from the front one. Drew's gonna stay right where she is. Doesn't have a target lock. Isn't going to be able to hit those missiles. It's not going well for our fellow 3.2 company podcaster Mike on the left-hand side of this list. Here comes Dengar. Just going to kind of slow in. Not worry about life. Just going to be looking to finish off Asajj. Looks like he has a little stress counter there. That must be from Zuckuss. I mean, the hardest part about this situation for Mike is even if he was able to wipe everything off the board, he has to deal with a Dengar that's rocking Painbot, Zuckuss, and is going to have to deal with a list. You know, and by the time Mike gets to Dengar, his list is going to be quite a bit depleted. All right, so here we go. Dengar on two. Lats is, I think, what we got. Must be a range one Dengar. One hit. So Wired's going to roll one into a blank. So one hit. Evade. We're going to have Zuckuss that, make him re-roll it into a blank. So that's one damage onto Asajj. But he's actually going to spend his Lats Razzie and not take the damage. That's one nice thing, Asajj versus a Zuckuss Dengar. No damage is going to be taken there. Trying to decide who Nadru is going to shoot. Range one at number one. Try to take it off the board before it can shoot at the Jakku Gunrunner. Let's see here. I think that's our shot. We're going to get... Or it might be range two. No, that's range one. Nothing. So, Palob now has a shot. Oh, nope. Asajj is now shooting. So I was going to shoot at the one that has concussion still. That's going to be range two. Two on two because Asajj has weapons failure. One crit. And focus. Does he spend it? Oh, he just has a target lock. He's going to take that crit. So there's the barrel roll onto the rock. Let's see what the roll is here. Nothing. So it takes one damage. That is number three. It's going to take a damage and a tractor beam token. So that's really good news for Mike. So now Palob's trying to decide on a target. You see the CLT Y-Wing? Do you shoot at the one in the front? What's your plan here, Palob? We really want to know. We're trying to see if we got an obstruction here. So we're doing range here. Probably should have checked earlier to see if Palob was in range to steal that token. All right, so I'm guessing Palob onto the Y-Wing range with TLT. Range doesn't matter. That's going to be one hit. Doesn't matter. So there's one. Second shot. And one hit and a blank. So two damage. So the Y-Wing takes two with TLT. All right, so now the Y-Wing should be up next. Y-Wing is going on Asajj. He's going to try to finish off Asajj, get him down to one hole here. That's the first one, three hits. So that's one damage, and second one is two hits. So we'll see a roll here for Asajj. Really rolling those dice in his hand. Oh no, that's two damage. There's a crit there. So Asajj is down to one hole currently. Alright, now we have... Oh, Asajj is gone. I don't know what I missed there. Dengar must have got a damage through. I apologize for that. So Dengar did get a damage through. I must have missed it. And Asajj is gone. That's a rough start here. Now we're going to move on and try to decide who the two Zs are going to shoot at. So, going on the Jakku Gunrunner. That looks like the right play, I would think. Two hits. Gunrunner's got a focus, but he rolled blanks. So, two on the Gunrunner there. And we got range two or three shy here. And one hit from the other Z. And here comes Mike throwing. There's the evade. So the Gunrunner will at least get a shoot. Which really wasn't that in doubt here. So now the Gunrunner is going to shoot back at, I'm not sure which ship. One hit from the Gunrunner. He's going to roll. Caleb's going to roll out. Made, so nothing really matters. Not that big of a deal at who he shot at. I'm not sure what I missed there. What he's measuring for. Oh, he's measuring to see if he can keep the target or the tractor beam token from Ketsu. Which I believe he was ranged 2 in arc, so he probably will. So we're at the planning phase. Mike is definitely in a pretty uphill battle here. Kind of misjudged with Asajj to start the game. Went into a joust with a bunch of missile boats and came out quite a bit behind in that exchange. Caleb still is full all the way up, so we'll see what the next round brings us here. This is the start of round four of this match. Round three of the Demolition Games Escalation Tournament here in Salt Lake City, Utah. This is 3.2 Company Broadcasting. We're a podcast here in Salt Lake. You know, we deal with, mostly we're X-Wing centric, but we also have been playing Star Wars Destiny. We have started a Edge of the Empire role-playing campaign that will also be podcasting / streaming on occasion. We actually did the Force Awakens box, and that will be the episode that goes out tomorrow on Sunday, is the part one of our Force Awakens beginner box RPG. So if you listen to it, I hope you enjoy it. It's pretty fun. 3.2 Company is kind of a play on Utah beer, is only 3.2 ABW. It's kind of notorious for being a weaker beer. We're here in the land of Zion. We like to drink, but unfortunately, it's a little bit weaker than normal, so we got to drink a lot extra. We do get salty. We do get drunk. It's definitely not safe for work. It's probably not safe to even listen to, but if you listen to it, we appreciate it. Just trying to figure out what he's going to do with Nadru here. Looks like the last... Nadru, and there's Dengar's dial. There's Nadru's dial. We're ready. So let's see what the Z's do. I'm guessing the most important thing the Z's really want to do in this situation is stop the Gunrunner from doing a tractor beam. So he's just going to swing out, maybe try to get into Palob's way. I like that. That Z has already shot its concussion missile. Has done a majority of its work helping Asajj get off the board. This looks like a one straight, clear your stress, set up a block on the Jakku Gunrunner, not going to let him have that target lock opportunity, or excuse me, that tractor beam opportunity with the space tug. This guy's on a rock, so he's going to have to roll. But he's also just going to slow roll off the rock. Definitely trying to get the Gunrunner into a situation where it's in a kill box, and also where it's not going to be able to get its tractor beam. Did we roll? Might have rolled. I might have missed it. Focus on the second one. I must have missed the roll on there. Let's go out and double check and see if we got any more damage. Jakku Gunrunner. He's gonna fit. Looks like he's gonna fit just fine. Here comes tractor beam. He's trying to decide which one he's gonna tractor beam. It's a good question. The thing is, I don't know if he can tractor beam it back on a rock. And he can't really track the beam out of power either. He probably does all the track to beam to Drew's path that Drew can do his K-turn or whatever his plans are. Oh, he's going to just track to beam Dengar. Oh, nope, there it is. Track to beam that one. Try to get it out of Drew's way, maybe. Move it as far forward as possible. Yeah. Here comes Palob. See what his plan is. Just going to go straight. Not worried about life too much. He's going to steal that token or two. Oh. Ah, Palob moved. Was planning on moving before the TLTY. So let's roll back that a little bit, and we'll get the TLTY moving away. Looks like he's going to do too hard there. Could be a three. Now Palob probably is going to bump. But nice thing about Palob, going to steal one of those tokens. Probably against the TLTY, most likely. Yeah, I'm going to check to see. Definitely a bump. Just going to slide him forward. He'll still get a TLT. Oh, he'll still get a token. No big deal there. Here comes Nadrew. K turning, it looks like. Kind of what I... Just gonna turn in. Maybe try to get in Dengar's way, maybe a little bit there. Takes the target line. Oh, gonna try to cluster Dengar. It's a dangerous situation. Dengar's gonna fire back, but maybe you can put like some heat on Dengar. Actually shoot your... You know, the thing I always feel like with Nadrew is you never get the opportunity to shoot your clusters because you're such a, you know, you're such a high-profile target. And that's probably, that's exactly why he tractor beamed the Z that he did to get it out of Nadru's way. Dengar's going to come in and bump his own guy because, of course, he didn't perceive that Z was going to be in tractor beam and get moved into his way. So I'm just going to kind of come in. We're not going to take a lot of time getting these bumps perfect. This is escalation. This is a fun tournament. We're just trying to have as much fun as possible. So not sure what they're discussing here. Probably trying to decide exactly how the bump should work. Remember, Dengar has Wired and Zuckuss, so he's still going to get rerolls. I think Dengar most likely bumped Nadrew there. If he didn't, that's scary for Nadrew, because she's going to definitely... Well, I mean, we'll see. Let's see who Dengar is shooting at. Looks like he's going to try to take out that Jakku Gunrunner, range 2. Maybe range 2. Yep. Thanks, Caleb, pointing out your shot. Except you're not rolling in the box. Oh, picked it up really quick. Hit crit. One of aid. So there's a crit onto the Gunrunner. Oh. He's going to make him re-roll it with Zuckuss. I'm guessing it was the one that gives you a stress. All right. So... Nadrew must be bumped against Dengar. They missed the opportunity, but Caleb let him have the token. Took it from the Z that was going to shoot at him. And trying to see if he can shoot at that Z over there with the tractor beam token. If the Jakku Gunrunner can stay alive long enough, can somehow, you know, dodge a TLT shot, he'll be able to shoot simultaneously. Pay lob on that guy. That's one. Okay, there's one. Second shot. Spend his focus. And needed it because he did 2 damage. And I believe that is on number 3. Oh, no, he's gone. 3's gone. Must have rolled the damage there. So, first blood is to Paylob on for Mike. Able to get one of the Z's, and the Z that still had his concussion missiles off the board. So that's good for him at least. So TLT is going to try to clean up the Jakku Gunrunner. Most likely is going to happen. So there's 2 hits. Need a double evade here. Doesn't get it. So there's 1. Second hit to see if the Jakku Gunrunner stays on the board. He does. So the Jakku Gunrunner will get his simultaneous shot at one of the Zs. That's important. For Mike to have a chance in this game. So here comes range one on the Gunrunner. To hit crit. If it's not blinded pilot, he gets a shot. Hold on 1 second.
Was it blinded pilot? Well, I know, but aren't they all PS1s?
Yeah, but I have a vision.
All right, sorry. So here comes the Jakku Gunrunner. Is going to do one hit. Okay, so didn't really matter. That must be on to Nadru, I guess. Oh, no, that's on to Palab. And Palab took a shield. They were a little too quick for me there. Sorry about that. I had to run out and double check. Palab is down. No shields. Quad jumper is off the board. And 1Z is off the board. This is when I need a second monitor, especially when I'm not co-piloting with anybody. It's hard to keep it updated and pay attention to the situation. So now it's definitely an uphill battle as Nadru and Palab are going to somehow try to get through this list with Dengar and a TLTY. The Z's currently, neither of the Z's for Caleb have any concussion missiles left. They've both shot their payloads. Nadru has not yet. So Nadru's going to try. Most likely we're going to see a K turn here from Nadru to somehow be able to shoot those clusters before she goes pop. It's going to be tough to do, especially going to be tough to do as you're probably going to see. What I'm guessing happens here is the Z that's in front of Dengar, that's Caleb's, he's just going to go as fast as possible and let Dengar do that two left sloop. And Nadru will do a 3K behind Dengar. Nadru will be able to shoot her cluster missiles, but won't have a focus to modify one of the shots. And Dengar is going to be able to double tap on Nadru and probably get her off the board. That's just my guess. Palab can be a pain. Can definitely, get in the way. The Z is just going to kind of just try to stay in Palab's way. That probably signals to me that his Y-Wing's going to, turn left to maybe try to block Palab in front of the Z. So here we go. Oh, no. I mean, he's probably still out of Dengar's way there. But that would be a real bummer if you somehow try to two sloop and you bump your own guy. So maybe he's not. Maybe he's just going to. Maybe he's just going to swing in on Palab. I mean, that he probably has room to two sloop there anyway. This, you know, with the camera being the way it is, it's not super easy to judge distances. And I'm not real good at judging distances anyway. So, I don't know. Why are we just going to turn out the other way? I like that move. He's going to be able to keep TLTing Palab. He wins in the long run when it comes to that fight. Palab dies much quicker than the TLTY. And he's kind of created a little kill box here with the other Z moving in onto Palab as well. Palab just going to too hard into a bump here. Yeah. Seems good. I'm guessing he's going to steal the token of the Y-Wing? I mean, is there a good token to steal here? Not really. You know, maybe you steal the token of the Z so you can try to put some damage on it. There's the 3K. That's probably the least shocking move of the game. Nadru trying to 3K to actually shoot her missiles. Now this is like scary Nadru, right? You got cluster missiles. You have Lone Wolf active and you have Nadru active. This is a scary situation for Dengar. He'll be okay. Oh, nope. Dengar slow rolls. Doesn't go for the two sloop for the double tap. Interesting. Loses a stress, it looks like. Nadru still has a target lock. Dengar probably shoots at Nadru here. Oh. So Nadru's glitter stimming. Great idea. And Palab stole a token. Not yet. So let's see if he remembers to do Palab this time or if Caleb bails him out again. As we're trying to see here, Dengar. Oh, no, here we go. He's thinking about Palab. I mean, it's not. There's not an easy answer to this question. Yeah, it takes the Z's. Maybe he can do a little bit more damage to the Z here. Do some work, as you were. Dengar's going to shoot at Palab, I'm guessing. I'm not 100% sure who this is on. Lone Wolf, Wired into two hits. Double evade. Doesn't even matter who he's shooting at there. Oh, no, he's going to Zuckus him. Into one evade. A blank and a focus. Was that on Nadru, I'm guessing?
I'm guessing you shot at Nadru there? Yeah. I was like, oh, that must have been Nadru.
Okay, so he was shooting at Nadru. Nadru lone wolfed and then glitter stimmed. So here comes cluster missiles into Dengar. Spend your target lock. Here you go. Cluster missile number one. That'll do. That'll do just fine. Three hits and a crit. One evade from Dengar. Doesn't get to wire that. So that's three shields off Dengar for the first attack. And he didn't use his guidance ships there. And Painbot, nothing. So second attack. So lone wolf roll. And there's three more hits. So that's four hits. So this is going to be seven damage on Dengar. Nope, he gets five damage on Dengar. So he's able to get rid of the shields and put a hole into Dengar. That's not bad. That is not bad. So Dengar is down to four hole. Lost all his shields. And this is Palab. Oh, no, that's got to be Palab shooting at something there. That's a wired roll. Missed the roll. Thinking about a focus spend here. Guessing he did it. It's got to be Dengar. I have no idea what just happened there. Zuckus rolling, I guess, with the. So here's the second TLT. And wired, so two hits. Doesn't matter. So Dengar is down to one hole. Dengar is down to two hole, I believe. There's a lot of rolling there, and I missed a little bit of it. But it's because of Palab has Zuckus, and Dengar had Wired, and just all kinds of nonsense going on there. I need a co-host. So it looks like we have the Z. Did we miss the TLT shot? I don't know why the Z shooting already. Nothing there. They shot, he did a little bit out of order. We're not going to worry about it. We're going to go for it. So here's TLT onto Palob, I believe. So TLT one. That's two. Going to save his focus, it looks like. Yep. So one. So one more damage onto Palob. TLT two. And two again. Spend his focus that time. Nothing. So two more damage onto Palob. Okay, so I'm going to run out, double check, see how close I am when it comes to what the situation is. I believe I have everything right. I believe Dengar's down to two hole, Palob's down to two hole, and the Y-Wing has two shields gone, and then Binyari number one has one shield gone. The other pirate is full health, and the Drew is full health. I'm going to double check. Stay with us. This is 3.2 Company streaming our escalation tournament round three at Demolition Games in Salt Lake City, Utah. Bear with me while we go and I double check. All right, just double checking the board state. Yeah, this is what it looks like. Dengar with two hole. Palob with two hole. Binyari 2 is full health. Binyari 1 is down a shield. The Y-Wing is down two shields. And Nadru is at full. This is a very tight game. Very interesting situation we have coming up. The one Y-Wing is probably... Depending on the situation, I think you turn three hard in here. I mean, you have unhinged. You're not worried about going slow. You turn three hard in to make sure, or at least try your best to keep Palob in your TLT range. Palob is stressed, so can't use that amazing dial that the Hawk somehow was gifted with. The Drew most likely just slow rolls or, you know, tries to keep the pressure on Dengar and keep Lone Wolf and her pilot or his or her pilot ability. Does anybody know if Nadru is male or female? I do not. I'm going to Google that. So, going to Wikipedia here, Nadru Sulik was a hunt saboteur during the Bounty Hunter Wars and a former rebel. Actually got kicked out of the Rebel Alliance for insubordination and for excessive insubordination. And it's a he. Nadru is a he. So, there we go. Twice he intervened in Boba Fett's business. But Nadru is actually legend, so all of this is moot when it comes to canon today.
If Dengar gets killed by a lower PS ship, does he still get to fire back with his pilot ability?
I believe so. Ask Tater. He'll know for sure. I'm pretty sure he does.
Yes.
Just trying to figure out. I mean, this is a pretty pivotal point in the game. You know, for a bad start that Mike had, I think he's done really well getting back into the game and at least making it interesting. I know he felt like after the second round that he just wanted to scoop and move on to the fourth round. But he stuck with it, and I think that's key. I mean, this is just for fun. Caleb has done very well. Ordnance is just still like such a big part of the meta currently, and like such a dangerous part of the meta. Even like PS1 Z's coming at you can be absolutely terrifying. Let's look at really quick. Let me pull up these guys' list for the fourth round. I can kind of give you a heads up of what they're planning to go into. Really quick, we'll start as they're moving here. Let's see what this first Z does before we get too crazy with the new hot topics. So he's going to try to stay either on Palob, right? Maybe Palob goes right in front of him, gets a range one shot onto Palob, stays in the donut hole of the Hawk, or, you know, gets the block in on Palob. Both of those are good, good outcomes, I think, for that pirate. Let's see what this Z does. I'm guessing a 3K here, just try to get behind Palob. And maybe move back into the fight while they're doing this movement here. Yeah, definitely probably a 3K. Let's go over really quick Caleb's list for the fourth round. So the lists obviously stay the same for escalation. Nothing's going to change from what he has on the board currently. He's going to add another TLT Y-Wing. So this list already super consistent when it comes to damage output, especially if you count the Z-95s as consistency with their concussion missiles. If he gets to fire those missiles, generally he's getting four hits. That's just the way it's going to go. He's adding another TLT Y-Wing with unhinged astromech. And it looks like Dengar is going to pick up the Punishing One title. So the fourth round, this list gets a lot scarier with a punishing one time. Okay, so the Y-Wing is just going to one forward, not get too crazy. Try to keep Palob within range three. If he gets the block with that Z, Palob's definitely going to take a TLT here. Let's see what Palob does. Yep, got the block. Palob turned in. It's going to take at least two shots. I'm probably going to take a shot from Dengar. I think Caleb tipped his hand a little bit at what he plans on because he was asking if he gets to return fire even if he's blown up. So let's see what Nadru does. Nadru's going to slow roll. Take a one forward. Nadru shot her clusters. Feels really good about the five damage she put into Dengar. And is just going to try to keep the pressure on. Dengar's going to do a two sloop here. I think he he definitely telegraphed it when he was asking if he gets to fire back, even if he's destroyed. But I kind of thought he was going to do it last round, to be honest. And like when he takes that cluster to maybe put some damage into Nadru. Dennis joining us at the table. Dennis, how'd your game go?
Pretty good, man.
Yeah.
Lost Asajj, kept all my Y-Wings alive.
Oh, nice.
So
what did you, so you have Asajj and how many TLTs?
Three right now.
Three right now. So your list is just dick to the nth degree. I like it.
Yep.
So Nadru trying to decide what she wants to do. She's double stressed. She did a K-turn and Glitter Stim last round. So now he's just trying to decide. I'm not sure what we're trying to do right here. Oh, it looks like Dengar is going to shoot at Palob. Mm. So let's see what Dengar does. That's two hits. Oh, maybe that was one hit. I'm not sure.
Looks like a focus.
Yeah. So double focus, and he'll Zuckus them, make him re-roll them into double, and Palob goes down. Because, of course, Zuckus continues his dominance.
I think Palob might have had three hull.
Did he have three?
Mm-hmm. So I think he's got one left.
Interesting. I thought Palob was gone, but I must have miscounted a little bit. I thought I was... So we're going to take Palob down to one hole, I'm guessing, is what that attack was. Or was that attack on the Drew, maybe? Let me double... I think he pointed at Palob, did he not?
I think he did.
Was that attack on Palob or the Drew? He has one hole left?
Yeah.
Okay.
So yeah, I was wrong. I took Palob down too far. Palob has one hole left. This is Nadru shooting at Dengar here. I'm guessing that's one or two. The one's hidden really hard. And double evade. Zucca. Oh, he doesn't have Zuckas. That's Palob. That's unfortunate because that was hit crit.
Yeah.
So now Dengar's going to shoot back.
Caleb's dice have been hot today.
Yeah. I'm not sure why Dengar didn't shoot back there. That's Mike rolling dice from Palob.
What, does he have a turret on Palob?
Yeah, he's TLT, yeah.
He's trying to decide if he wants him to suck his focus results.
But I don't think he has a focus, so.
But he's wired.
Oh, can you do both? Can you reroll both? Yeah. Or only one? Can you reroll
any
both?
Focus result when you're stressed.
Okay, cool. So Dengar is down to two hole. Here's the second. Oh yeah, down to one hole now. And so two with wired there. Zuckus, both of those obviously. Let's see if Zuckus can do what to Dengar. No. Nope.
Oh my gosh.
And he just scooped in anger. Angry scoop, I think, happened just there.
Did Palob just fly off the board?
I think he grabbed him and threw him off the board.
I heard a toop.
He's so angry. All right, so I think Palob's down to one. Dengar is also down to one somehow. That's brutal.
That is brutal.
That is brutal.
I think I'm going to have to play Palob next round, too.
Yeah, I mean, you know, to be honest, Mike miscalculated a little bit, and he jousted with Asajj when I think he was trying to bait the joust, and then it didn't work out.
Okay.
And,
because I'm on the opposite end. My red dice have been...
Oh, it must have been Painbot killed him. We must have missed the Painbot attack. Because he didn't roll it against Nadru, so he must have saved it for... So now, I don't think we have any other shots. So we should be at planning. I don't know what he's rolling here.
I don't know who's rolling three dice for him.
It's got to be the TLT on Palob. Maybe he just took it off the board because he knows he's dead. Mm. Missed, apparently. There's two crits. All right, I'm guessing that's on Palob.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I was going to say, well, I was wondering, did you pain bot Palob? No?
No.
Okay. So Palob is now officially with the fishes. The TLTY was able to. Now
Mike, you know Mike wears his emotions on his sleeve. I've in our last year, our drunk league, I watched him pick up a bunch of dice and huck them in the garbage, and go buy a new set. So. I mean, there's definitely some energy here. All in good fun. Caleb has had some hot greens in the last two rounds. It's been said a couple times today that he's rolling hot. So it can be frustrating when you feel like you got the big guy off the board and then he somehow stays alive with a double evade. Zuckus into double evades. So really quick, we're going to go over Mike's... Round 5, so everything stays the same, obviously. Round 5, he adds Drea with TLT and R4B11. Classic Drea.
Should be really fun. He kind of decided to come in and just like play like fun ships, you know. He loves Pelob, he loves Asajj, he loves Nidru. Wanted to play his quad jumper, hasn't played it yet.
Nice. I thought about putting Nidru in my list, but
yeah,
I just don't.
Nidru's hilarious. I love Nidru. I'm shocked that nobody's shot at Nidru yet. Like,
yeah,
you know, but I mean, he does have some scary stuff, and Asajj kind of was such a juicy target that he was able to put two concussions into Asajj and like two TLT shots.
Okay. I went up against four B-Wings with shield upgrade and FCS in the last game.
Yeah.
Asajj just went up the board and turned once and died.
Yeah, that will happen.
So.
That's a lot of dice.
That is too many dice.
12 dice with fire with target locks is scary.
Mm-hmm. At one point, I managed to triple stress. I got three different stress tokens out on B-Wings.
Ugh.
One from he had a red move, one I assigned, and the last one I hit him and barrel rolled him onto debris.
Jeez.
And I rolled more evades that turn than I have most of the day.
Yeah, there's been a couple missed opportunities in this game. The first round of shooting, Mike forgot that he could assign the tractor beam. He could have put a Z on a rock that would have shot a concussion missile at him.
Okay.
So he forgot to do that, so that Z was able to unload its concussion. Didn't forget the next round, the Jakku Gunrunner put another Z with the tractor beam out. So there's just been kind of a couple miscues for Mike. And yet he's still super in this game.
Mm-hmm.
But now we're going to see Dengar just continue to do the two left sloop because that seems fair. And
how many stress tokens is Caleb up to?
I don't know. He's up to quite a few. Looks like Dengar's going to shoot into Nidru, obviously, because that's his only option. Two crits. There's a focus there. He's going to Lone Wolf and miss that one and take two shields, it looks like. Yep, both shields are gone. Really quick. See if I can do this fast. I need a mouse, Tater. That was bullshit. Pad thing. Alright, so I'm not sure who Nadru's shooting at here.
I don't think he has
on to that. Either. Yeah, so two hits. Must be three because he didn't re-roll. And that looks like blanks
that
to me.
Looks
like blanks. I want to go to the scene. Left hand is really hard. That Z is gone.
Nice.
So that must be number one because number two is full health. So hey, there's some more points.
There you go.
Yeah, I think, you know, I don't want to give him O2. I hate Max. I just hate him to death.
Mm-hmm. I don't know how to use him.
So now he must have Arc with that Z up the top there. Does that work? Yeah, that works. Cool. They've really moved my... That's a hit crit. Caleb just continues to be on fire. That's a lot of dice. So I don't know what happened there. He must have been safe.
Yeah, the last two maybe evade results.
Yeah, okay. So, yeah, we're just moving on. I mean, I think Nidru, does she not have Arc there? Or does she just decide that if Dengar has return Arc, that there's no point in trying to kill him? Because
yeah.
You're going to die back with Zuckuss on the board? I mean, I think if I'm Mike, I just try to kill Dengar and like cut my losses. I want to get the because right now if he doesn't, you know,
kill Dengar, yeah.
He's got like what 16 points with the Z and 25 points with the TLT. And Dengar's more than that.
Mm-hmm.
So
plus the Z's full health and the
TLT's way too
without real good luck.
Yeah,
in one go.
Yeah, you basically need hit, crit, blank, and then a direct hit on the Z to have a chance.
Mm-hmm.
So, but I don't know if he ever even gets another shot on Dengar.
Not out of Arc.
Yeah, not out of Arc, or even, you know.
This next round, he's probably going to be taking shots from all three.
Yeah, or Dengar just goes for the bump.
Yeah, oh yeah.
And just, you know, let the TLT kill Nidru.
Mm-hmm.
You know, make a little kill box with the Z and the TLT, and then bump with the, well... I guess Nidru will move before Dengar, so I'm an idiot.
But still, if Dengar can force the bump and not be shot at.
Yeah, exactly. Force the bump, not take the shot. No chance that he's going to die. Yeah, there's the TLT just flying in, mm-hmm. making sure gets a shot. And take a focus. And a Drew, slow roll with the one forward or go with the 3K? Just flying in, not even K turning.
I was going to say, if he did a 3 bank, he might have ended. Well, he's going to be range 1 of the Y, but...
Range 1 of the Y. I thought maybe the 3K just to make sure that he could shoot Dengar. At Dengar, maybe. Because what's Dengar doing here? He's losing a stress, so that means he's doing a 1 straight. Okay. Yep. So, yeah, Nadru won't even get a shot here. Range 1. Not sure what I'm Caleb's saying. I think Caleb's talking shit right now.
Probably. Bastard. I wish I could have seen the space tug.
Yeah, I mean, action. Yeah, it was cool. I mean, once you get into range, though, they just immediately just turn on it, you know. So two hits from Dengar. Here comes Nadru. Lone Wolf. That looks like a focus to me. And that's an evade. Now Dengar can use Zuckus now. Oh, no, he didn't. Go ahead and Zuckus. I'm not sure why.
I'm not either.
I think he Zuckus that focus.
I think, yeah, he used his focus. Still yeah. 2 health. Wow.
So now on to the Y-Wing. Oh, he rolled some greens. Let's try that again. Let's try that again, Mike. It's been one of those games.
Tricked ya.
That's worse. You should have kept the reds that you rolled with the greens. There's Lone Wolf. And now why? Oh, no, he didn't. That's Palob. And... He'll spin just to be a... Oh, no, he didn't spin. I was going to say, I'd spin just to be a dick.
Nope, you don't get that point.
So one damage on the Y. Not even going to upload it. I don't even care. That's a primary.
Yeah.
So 3 on 2. Yeah, now he spins.
Yeah.
2 hits. So here comes right, Drew again.
2 evades.
Need some... So there's 1 evade. He can now Lone Wolf, correct? Or is it blanks only? So... That's 1 damage.
Oh no, he's got 1 health left, right?
Yes, that's 1 damage. So now the Z has to finish it off. Mm-hmm. Range 2. We'll update the score in just a second, everybody. So, 1 hit. And there's an evade, so he's still alive. So we got Nadru down to 1 hole. And the Y-Wing lost another shield. I believe that's the situation. He didn't spend his focus on defense. He spent it on offense. We're going to give it another shot here. So now here's the interesting thing for Nadru. You could K-turn here and shoot it Dengar. And oh, wait, no. That stupid one heart is white, isn't it, to the right?
Yeah.
I was thinking he couldn't one heart because he's stressed. But no, that ship doesn't have any stress.
No.
Like, I think... More annoying than anything with the ship having the 2 white sloop is that none of the right moves are red besides
the two hard
is, and then the 2 sloop right.
Yes,
is red.
The 2 red moves.
But like everything should be red on the right side, I think.
If you're gonna give them all greens on the left.
Yeah. There's so many mistakes made on that ship. There's so many mistakes. That ship. I mean, if you go back, I'm gonna get on my high horse and beat the shit out of it till it's dead for the 1,000th time. What I've done. But the contracted scout costs 25 points. The PS1 Star Viper costs 25 points. Its dial is way worse than the Jumpmaster. Its PS is 2 worse than Jumpmaster. Does not have an EPT and doesn't have 12 other upgrades it can take.
Yep.
Can't get its system slot. Can't take the title because it's not over PS like 5. Rabble, 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 rabble.
I can't even remember what the Star Viper title does.
Virago, it gives you an illicit slot and a system slot, which should just be natural on that ship. It should have an illicit slot and a system slot.
It doesn't come with 1 illicit slot already?
No. That's how you get the illicit. And it's a unique title, so only 1 of them can take it.
Figures the leader of Black Sun wouldn't always have illicit with him.
I mean, that's the problem I think that scum ships really got into at the start, the small base ships, is fluff got in the way of good gameplay. Mm-hmm. Like, the unique scum ships. Like, the Hawk is fine. The Z is fine.
Yeah.
The Y-Wing is amazing.
Yeah.
better than the Rebel Y-Wing.
Yep.
And the Hawk is better than the Rebel Hawk, mm-hmm. and the Z is sixes.
Yeah.
The Zs are Zs. Mm-hmm. Though I would argue Nadru's better than either Blount or whatever the other one's Kraken. Name is, Kraken, because I don't even care. But I hate Rebels, so I think everything's better.
Yeah.
or worse, depending on the day and depending on what we're talking about. But yeah, they let fluff get in the way. They make the they took all the lessons they'd learned from the X-Wing and then didn't learn anything from it and just did the same mistakes when they did the Kirass.
Yeah.
they learned nothing from the Y-Wing or from the X-Wing and just continued to make it. They made an even worse X-Wing with the Kirass. It doesn't have an astromech slot. It doesn't have a one straight.
And the missing three hards is pretty brutal on
yeah.
that dial.
I think the one straight's the worst part, though. Mm-hmm. They can't slow roll, and they want to joust.
Yeah.
Like, oh, wait, what? The Sick they made, they had an interesting idea with the Sick, right? They wanted to make
cheap,
a cheap cannon.
Yeah.
Or a cheap, you know, carrier of some
yeah.
type. And I think they've done loads to make it better. The new title adding a hole is nice.
Yeah.
The Light Sick title, when it comes out, will be an interesting Manaru alternative. Other than, you know, by that time, I'm sure the rabble crowd will have turned on a Tawny Mind Link to make it worse.
Yep. I was going to say, the cheapest Mind Link carrier you can make is a Light Psych for 16 points.
Yep.
Total.
It's crazy.
It's pretty good. I really want to work one.
Yeah, because you would never, you would just sit in your corner. Mm-hmm. You would never leave.
Yeah, just fly along the back edge of the board.
And it has an evade token, so if it has to, it can just take an evade.
Mm-hmm. And three green dice.
Yeah, and get a focus, you know? So.
I was looking at using it as a support.
So range two or three there. Look like two. That's really glary, but that looked like one hit.
Wired, one focus.
Wired into it, yep. And there's blank, it looks like. Do we have a handshake? We had a handshake off screen.
No lone wolf?
He should have lone wolf there, but I think he just didn't care.
He's just done. He could kill Dengar.
Yeah, he could have. He should have. That was a good game, though, everybody. Hey, thanks for watching. Give us a second. We'll get Mike back here to rage about his game. in round four, we'll be up momentarily. I mean, not momentarily. We definitely still have probably like 15, 20 minutes of this round. These are getting to be longer rounds. This was a 90-minute round.
Definitely got some games still running.
There's a lot of ships still on the board in a lot of these games. Caleb coming back with some swagger. Jack Swagger Caleb.
Until I realize I have to play Dennis in the
yeah.
in the final, and that's going to suck.
I think it's going to be exciting.
Asajj and four TLTs against my Z95s? He's going to eat me alive, man.
Well, I mean...
You have some. Yeah, ooh, you finally get the title on Dengar.
I do get the title on Dengar.
I think you'll be all right. So.
I think it'll be pretty good, honestly.
So nice Angry matchup. Mike coming back with some birds behind the back on Caleb. So... Let's talk about this game really quick, Caleb.
Here, sure.
Grab this chair here. One of you two here. Dennis, don't leave. Since this is our preview of the final as well.
Oh, cool.
We
yeah,
got
nobody else would be 3-0, right?
Nope. Yeah. You and I were.
Yeah, so this is if we had an opportunity here, we could weigh them in and get them putting their fists up to each other's face for the final. Maybe I'll do that off camera and we'll add it to our
nice.
Slack chat. I mean, excuse me, our Facebook chat. So, Caleb, run us through that game. I think you had... an interesting setup. I think, unfortunately, Mike's game plan at the start didn't really work out for him. And a missed opportunity on the tractor beam token really hurt, too. But on the
yeah,
whole,
that
I
led
think,
to him taking a concussion missile, otherwise.
Yeah,
he
I mean,
Asajj
makes it one more round.
So as far as my setup went, my whole plan was I wanted to make him move first. So I put Dengar way over on the side because he likes to go left. I spread the Zs out a little bit because in my previous games they'd been a lot closer together and it had hurt me, so I wanted to give them a little more freedom. And then the Y-Wing was just over, slow rolled. Really didn't expect Mike to bring Asajj right into the face of all that ordnance.
Yeah, that wasn't my plan either.
Yeah. And so Asajj went down really fast.
Yeah, I think the real turning point in the game was Dengar staying alive. After Asajj had ripped into her.
Yeah, he had no business still being on the board with Nadru rolling all that damage on those cluster missiles.
Yeah, and then the next round rolling Zuckus into double evade, into Zuckus double evade.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was brutal for my... And I think the game still probably skews in your favor, even if that goes through. But yeah, that was a pretty big turning point. I mean, yeah, Zuckus...
I mean, Dengar getting the double evade on the second cluster also was a big, big
help. Yes.
It was a pretty crazy game, though. I think at the start, specifically me watching and talking to myself as we went through this game, I was like, oh, this did not go the way Mike went. And he fought back, got back into the game, made some good moves.
Took down a Z in the end there.
Took down a Z. I think he missed a Lone Wolf reroll at the end that he could have tried to Lone Wolf back into that evade.
He might have, yeah.
So he could have shot again. I think he was a little bit over this game.
Where did Pelov end up? Oh, there he is. Well, he ended up pretty far away.
Yeah, he threw him against the wall.
Did he really?
Yeah. After I rolled the double evade on the
evade.
He just scooped Pelov and slammed him against the wall and went everywhere. But he wasn't dead yet. He still had a hole, so
yeah.
I made sure we rolled the Y-wing TLTs to actually kill him.
To make sure
it was all legit.
Well, sweet. I think we're going to keep the top table on the stream, obviously, so we'll see you next round.
Awesome. I don't have to move my stuff this time.
Well, we'll see your addition of the title onto Dengar and another TLTY. That's terrifying.
Yeah.
All right, sweet. Thanks, everybody, for watching this round. We will be back soon again. I don't know the timeline, but we probably still have 20 minutes of this round.
Yeah, we're probably at least 15 minutes or so.
Cool. So we'll be back. Caleb's going to stay where he's at. I'm just going to add another TLT to his list. We're going to get Dennis's list fired up. And we will be back in just a moment or two. Thanks for watching. 3.2 Company at Demolition Games in Salt Lake City.